Place your left hand on the Bible and raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
I do.
Please be seated.
So how do you feel about Felicia Jones, Dr. Chamberlain?
I loved her so much. Still do.
It's not just a physical attraction, then.
Well, there's certainly that, too, but there's much more. I want to marry her. Even now, I look at her and
Objection,
I think about what...
A simple yes or no answer is all that's required.
Sustained. Just answer the questions, Dr. Chamberlain. No editorializing.
Yes, Your Honor.
Doctor, you proposed Miss Jones in the past. Is that correct?
Yes, I did.
Will you describe for the court the circumstance surrounding that proposal?
Well, I had rented a cabin in the mountains. It was very isolated, very romantic. I guess I was trying to set a mood. I wanted everything to be perfect.
And was it?
Not even close.
Did you ask Miss Jones to marry you?
Yes.
And what was her response?
She attacked me.
Order.
She attacked you?
Yes.
With her fists?
No, with a knife. She almost killed me.
Well, what provoked this attack?
You know, to this day, I have no idea.
Did your feelings towards Miss Jones change as a result of this incident?
Well, if you're asking me if I still love her, the answer is yes, I do.
Well, you must have been devastated when you found out that she was killed in a car accident.
Objection, Your Honor. Leading the witness.
Sustained. I'll rephrase. Doctor, considering your feeling for Miss Jones, how did you feel when you found out she'd been killed?
I was shattered. I wanted to die myself.
And did you attend the so-called funeral?
Yes, I did.
Did you look in the coffin to ascertain that she was, in fact, dead?
Yes.
Did anyone see you do that?
As a matter of fact, Commissioner Donnelly was standing right next to me. He even opened the coffin lid so I could look inside. Max Scorpio was in the room somewhere, but I can't testify as to what he saw.
Well, is it safe to assume that when this dead woman appeared before you, after the funeral, made up to look like a ghost, that you were somewhat shocked?
I thought I was losing my mind. I mean, a little more every day. Seeing Felicia it was just the last straw, that's all.
Go on, if you can, elaborate.
Well, it was progressive, this haunting. First, it started with phone calls after I thought Felicia was dead. Anyway, the phone calls became more and more frequent. My cable television was rigged so that when I turned on the TV, I'd find Felicia on every channel. I'd get messages from her on my computer. Even when the equipment wasn't on, I'd just be sitting there and the screen would come up and words would start printing across the screen. It was harrowing, to say the least.
I could imagine. Doctor, would you like a minute?
No, I'm fine.
All right, moving on. Eventually, Miss Jones came to the hospital and confronted you directly. Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Tell the court what happened.
I was working late in my office, and she showed up on the other side of the door. I mean, first it was whispers, and then it got louder and louder.
What did she say?
She said things like, come to me, Ryan. I'm here for you, Ryan. Things like that.
And there was no doubt in your mind that it was Felicia?
No, none whatsoever. I recognized her voice.
How did you react?
Well, by this time, the games that had been playing on me had taken the desired effect. I was very confused, and I was disoriented. And I think I wanted her to be alive so badly that I'd actually begun to convince myself that the unthinkable was possible. I was frightened, too.
Your Honor, the witness has rambled on for so long, I've forgotten the question.
Is that an objection, Counselor, or a protest, an observation?
Objection, Your Honor.
Overruled.
Dr. Chamberlain, you stated that you were frightened.
Yes.
Why? If you loved this woman so much.
You have to understand how confused I was, how disoriented I really was. I believed that Felicia was dead. And yet there she was, right in front of me. I thought I was looking at a ghost. Her skin was kind of grayish white. She seemed to move differently. She kept talking to me in this eerie monotone. I was petrified. I don't mind saying that. I really thought she could hurt me, and there is somewhat of a history in that area, you know.
Indeed. I'd like to direct your attention now to the accusations that Steve and Audrey Hardy made against you. Did you attack them, Dr. Chamberlain?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No. I have no memory of that incident at all. If they say it happened, then it must be true. I know Steve and Audrey Hardy to be honorable people. And I would like to apologize for any harm I may have caused.
Objection, Your Honor. The witness isn't winning an Academy Award. He's not allowed to make speeches.
Sustained. I won't warn you again, Dr. Chamberlain. Just answer the questions, nothing more.
Yes, Your Honor.
Doctor, if what the Hardys say is true, even though it's not part of your conscious memory, why would you feel compelled to attack them? Did you dislike them in any way?
No. No, not at all. Actually, I looked up to both of them. If I did this thing, then it had to be because I wasn't myself. I became a doctor to heal people, not to hurt them. The only explanation I have is that the games being played at my expense just made me fall apart.
Thank you, Doctor. No further questions, Your Honor.
We'll take a 15-minute recess before cross-examination.
All right.
Refer back to your previous testimony. You said you were in fear of your life when Felicia Jones came to you at the hospital.
Yes, that's right.
Why is that?
Because she tried to kill me at the cabin.
Well, I'm not asking you about the cabin. I'm asking you what Felicia Jones did to you to threaten you at the hospital.
Oh, she was stalking me, chasing me.
Did she have a weapon?
No.
Did she make menacing gestures?
No.
And yet you were so afraid of a ghost weighing no more than 110 pounds soaking wet. You're quite the he-man, aren't you, Dr. Chamberlain?
Objection. Badgering the witness. Sustain.
Did Felicia Jones chase you into the morgue?
I don't remember.
Oh, I see. Is this the part where your memory fails you?
Your Honor, this is outrageous. She's sneering at my client.
Miss Holmes, you will refrain from sneering at the witness.
Sorry, Your Honor. Dr. Chamberlain, on this most terrifying of nights, is it your testimony that you were also frightened for your life when Felicia Jones was hiding from you? And when you pulled the sheet off of her that was covering her, you said to her, and now you're going to have to die for real?
I never said that.
Were you reacting to terror when you tried to kill her?
I never did that.
Was it fear when you knocked her to the ground?
I never laid a hand on her. I would never hurt Felicia.
Bella? Your Honor, I'd like to introduce this autopsy knife, and please enter it as People's Exhibit 11. Thank you. Dr. Chamberlain, do you recognize this knife?
No.
Have you ever seen it before?
I've seen a lot of autopsy knives. I don't think I could pick that one out of a crowd.
Isn't this the knife that you used to threaten Felicia until Max Scorpio wrestled it away from you?
I told you, I never threatened Felicia with anything.
Well, then, can you explain to the court why your fingerprints are all over it?
No, I can't. All I can explain to the court is that I never did anything to hurt or threaten Felicia.
Oh, that's right, I forgot. You were the one in fear of your life.
Yes.
Bailiff, was it that same fear that prompted you to go over to Stephen Audrey Hardy's house and viciously attack them?
As I stated earlier, I have no recollection of the whole incident.
Quite the memory you have. Must come in handy.
Objection.
Withdrawn. No further questions, Your Honor.